going on, guys and girls? My name is James, or thanks to ya, and welcome back to another episode of Pixelmon here on the Pixel Core server. Welcome back, everyone. How are you all doing? Are you good? Yes, thank you for asking. I am very good. So, I've got a few plans for the next couple of episodes, some very exciting stuff that we're going to be doing, and I think the first thing I want to do on my list here is to actually make the rest of the pieces to actually make a fully functioning fossil extractor-style thing. So, remember when we derped up in the last couple of episodes? No, it was a little while ago now, actually, and we made ourselves this fossil cleaner, and I was like, oh, it's such a waste, we've got two in there. Well, that's actually used as one of the parts for the actual full fossil machine, and I thought it might be quite cool to have our own version of that. So that's going to involve me going away and doing some mining, which isn't going to be too exciting. So I'll probably do the majority of that off screen, although if I find anything cool, I will jump straight back in. And yeah, as well as that, I want to start getting together some orbs in order to try and catch some of these legendary birds. Now, how that works is effectively you need to find shrines, which will be randomly spawning in respective biomes, and you need to kind of like charge the orb. So we've got a choice now of either Zapdos, Moltres, or Articuno to start off with. Now, unfortunately, because I don't have a Thunderstone or a Firestone, we don't even have a Waterstone either. Damn it. So I think one of the things we're going to do is try and get some fragments so we can actually get one of those. I do actually have my orb here, but we do need to like use that with a stone in order to get the stone of the frozen or the thunder or the fire, and then we need to charge that, and then we need to use that on a shrine as and when we find it. So we can't really control that at the moment, but what we can control is starting to extract some fossils, and apparently you can find fossils in gravel as well, so that's going to be really cool whilst I'm mining. Unfortunately, the thing is, we're kind of relatively unprepared in terms of the gear that we've got in terms of mining, so I'm going to have to make it as and when. So I've got a couple of wood blocks left over from my doings. I think we got some more at the house. Ooh, I'm going to show you this quickly, actually. I've been doing a little bit of work on the treehouse. We need to name this, by the way. Oh, God. Oh, it's a level 7 liquid. Come on now, body slam. Have I missed? I can't believe I just missed. Why wouldn't you die? Dynamic punch it. That's such overkill. Why wouldn't you die? There we go. So, yeah, I've got to stick some of this in there for now. So, yeah, I've been doing a little bit of work on the treehouse here. So if we walk in, I'm quite happy with this. Da-da-da! We have, like, some little references to the original gen Pokemon. So these are just pictures, by the way. The pictures in this are really, really good. So these are just, like, you know, picture frames that you can make paintings, I should say. So we got a Venusaur here with a bit of green carpet. We've got a Charizard here with some red carpet. And we've got a Blastoise with some blue carpet. Don't really know what I want to do. I want to kind of theme these walls in the different ones, so maybe like water and then fire and then grass. Grass is okay, I can do vines and stuff. Fire's going to be a bit more difficult because I could burn down my entire house. And water, don't really know, but maybe we could do some little waterfall-y things. But yeah, if you come up the stairs, I've got some further references to the original gen. So we've got a little Squirtle, got a little Charmander, got a little Bulbasaur. And then I've not really done too much up here, just a few more picture frames. I went a bit picture frame mad. So we've got Pikachu, Treecko, I think. And I've completely forgotten what you're called. Totodile, I think. And, oh God, staircase is a bit dodgy. And then we just got a couple of balls here. So we've got a Pokeball, a Great Ball, an Ultra Ball. And obviously, because I don't have a Master Ball, which I would have liked to have put up there, it's just a Dusk Ball for now. Our Epicorns are growing really, really quick. So let's just harvest some of these quickly. Come on, give me them. Give me all of your sweet things. And I can use these apricorns in crafting recipes, so that's the reason why I'm sort of trying to set up a little farm here, so we can kind of craft some bits and pieces using them. Let's just grab all of these here quickly. So yeah, that's kind of what I've done with the house, nothing too special. And then I actually cleaned out this area here, because I thought this would make an extra little area. I don't really know what to put in here just yet, but it has a really nice view. I can keep an eye on Justin in his house. I can see you. So, yeah, I thought that was quite cool. And as well as that, I want to try and get some TMs as well, so we can actually start using, you know, surf and fly and all that stuff, which will make life much, much easier than just sailing a boat around, which is kind of what we have to do at the moment. So let's grab some wood, because you never know when you need wood. Let's grab ourselves our balls out, just in case we meet anything amazing. That's not how we do it, is it, James? No. There we go. So I've got one pickaxe, which is iron. I've got a stone thingy. I've got a shovel. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm basically going to have to mine out some iron, then make some better tools with that, and then hopefully have a bit of a sesh to try and get some resources together. We need a lot of the plated, what is it, aluminium? I can't remember. We need some of that ore that makes the aluminium plates so that we can make ourselves the rest of this gear. So let me just show you that quickly. I was doing a bit of research here. The fossil machine, we need a lot of aluminium plates. So we have our... have we made one of those already? Oh, I don't think we made one of those. Oh, it's a different thing, but it looks exactly the same. No, it doesn't look the same at all. I ignore the first 30 seconds of this video. So we're going to need obsidian, we're going to need redstone. That's not too bad. This one's easy, it's just water buckets and glass, but of course we're going to have to get the iron for those. The top bit is more aluminium plate and redstone, the bottom bit is just aluminium plate. So once we've got all four of those, we can start extracting fossils, which should be pretty cool. Going to see some Pokemon that we wouldn't necessarily see spawning. So that's kind of the plan for this episode, try and crack on with that. Unfortunately, no more legendaries have spawned. Since our last occasion, which is exciting. I do believe Justin actually has one of the legendary birds, so I'm super jealous of that. But I do have a Kyogre. That's pretty cool in itself. But yeah, as of yet, no more legendary prompts, which is a bit of a shame. I need to go make some boats. The question is there a crafting table in here? I think so. I think I put one in here, didn't I? Ekans! Yes, I did. Fantastic news. Thunderstone! You're welcome, thanks to you. I've already used it. It was very useful, though. Wood. Alright, so let's make a couple of these. That'll probably do. And, yeah, what I'm going to do is... I remember there's a lot of good areas sort of that direction. So I think that's where we're going to go to do our little mining expedition to start off with. Hopefully we can get some pretty cool stuff. Now, the water shards aren't particularly difficult to get. I can get access to quite a lot of those, but it's the other ones that are a little bit tricky. We're actually going to run there right to the coast because you never know. Ooh, there's a serving here. That's cool. We're going to run there because you never know when you're going to find a boss. And this is the beauty of the Pixelmons. And I forgot to heal my main... I forgot to heal Dave, which was a bit of a silly. But I think... everyone else is good. There's not that many things that spawn in these underground systems. We were quite lucky last time because we found a boss Diglett, which was a completely random thing to find, but we did find one, which is pretty cool. So that's always useful to know. But there isn't that much underground, especially when we leave the main island. But yeah, I also need to make a bike. Yeah, that would be useful as well. So there's plenty to do. I'm really, really excited, actually. We've got loads of stuff that I want to do. Ooh, very cool. I keep seeing, like, Pokemon that we haven't ever seen before, which is really cool. Like, the Pixelmon 3 is pretty big, you know, there's a lot of Pokemon around, but, yeah, it's cool to see sort of newer ones that you wouldn't necessarily see, every other day. Oh, God, that was terrible. Jump! Yes! Okay, so I'm actually wondering as well what other legendaries will spawn. I do know that a Rayquaza, whichever one you want to say, that does spawn, but obviously very rarely. I think it's 1 in 15,000, so to have two chances at the same legendary is pretty damn lucky, I've got to say. We did luck out quite a bit there. It's pretty cool. What's that? Have I been here before? I think if we've been here before, I remember that tree. It's quite fancy. And that is a massive Voltorb. Electrode, sorry. I want to see what this statue is. I don't think I've seen that before. Have I? Let's go and investigate. Investigation. Oh, is that Pikachu? I think so. I don't know, but it's got a button on its nose, and I kind of want to press it, but I don't think it'll do anything. Oh, that's pretty cool, isn't it? Oh, God. Don't run into you. And as well as that, oh, I actually really, 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 really want to catch another Dratini if I ever see one ever again. I failed miserably the last time, but I'd love to get a Dragonite. I think that would be a really good example. I've had a few, I've had a few suggestions from people which are like, yeah, you should catch a Dragonite. That would be cool. So I'd really, really like to catch a Dragonite at some point. A Dragonite, catch a Dratini and sort of level it up that way. We could have had one. We were so close. But so far. The cruelness of Pixelmon. Dun, 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 dun. So yeah, this is kind of where I came last time. And I sailed off in this direction. So, Squirtle. This is a good spot, I think. So yeah, I am going to sail away in this direction. and hopefully try and find some kind of underground systems. Hopefully it goes nighttime, because the best way to find these underground systems in this particular server is to like look for lava light underneath the water, and then chances are it's going to be a ravine, and chances are it's going to have some cool stuff in it. So that's kind of how I've been doing it up until now, but I do really need to do a big mining cess, which is what I'm going to do at the moment. So yeah, if I meet anything cool along the way, I will let you guys know. But yeah, I'll see you all in a little while. Okay, welcome back. So yeah, I managed to find a ravine. Finally, it did take quite a while this time, I've got to say. But we're down at pretty much lava level, which is very, very useful. And I've been kind of slowly but surely mining away. So my pictures broke, which is a little bit of bad news. But the good news is we found some obsidian here. We found some lava, but we've got to be careful because it might kill us all. Let me just brick some of that up. Actually, it's quite deep in that particular place. So yeah, what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to make myself our first diamond pickaxe. But yeah, I just wanted to show you the system that I found, because it looks pretty cool. So yeah, we managed to find ourselves some diamonds here, so let's make ourselves, ta-da! Wow, the diamond pickaxe looks awesome! So I can't quite remember how much obsidian we need, but I'm probably going to grab, I'll grab like 3 or 4 pieces for now. Because it's probably better to have a little bit more than a little bit less. We've managed to find 19. Actually, I'll do a little inventory stock take here in a second. Let me just grab a couple of these pieces. Yeah, that did take quite a while, because I couldn't find like a surface ravine, so I had to kind of do a little bit of digging from... There's like above me, there's sort of 3 or 4 little islands, so I managed to jump on one of those, have a little look around, and by pretty much sheer fluke, I managed to find myself a ravine. The ravines are the best place to find loads of stuff, in my opinion. I'm sure you already know that. But yeah, there's loads and loads of ores and stuff down here, which is pretty cool. I have managed to find myself some redstone. There's not very many Pixelmon spawning around here, because it's just so deep and really far away from civilization. But yeah, hang on. All right, so let me just grab this one piece here. Let me show you. Right, so what we have is we have 19 pieces of bauxite, which is good. I want to get loads of bauxite because we're going to need lots of the aluminium plates. We've managed to find ourselves some gold ore. We have 3 diamonds. We got our obsidian. We got some lapis. We've got some redstone. But yeah, this is the system. Let me just get through this here. Fight our way up the stream. Come on. There we go. So this is the system I found. Really, really cool looking, I think. And I've kind of worked my way down from that direction into this direction. So that's kind of where I am up to right now. I'm going to be fighting my way through there. And then I'm probably going to go up a little bit, hoping there'll be some branch off caves. I don't think there's anything really left down here apart from coal. I have been doing a little bit of digging in some gravel. So I haven't found any fossils. I hope I didn't misread that, or I could just be wasting my time. But loads and loads of flint. I don't think we really need flint for anything. That's my shovel gone anyway. I do actually have some iron, so I might have to build a furnace and do some smelting. But, ooh, didn't see this gold. Yoink. I shall take you. Thank you very much. Come on. Grab it. There we go. Just brick that up. Come on. Ah, missed. There we go. So, anyway, I'm going to continue what I'm doing down here. And, yeah, if I see anything really, really cool, I'll let you know. But if not, I'll meet you guys back at the house. And we can work on making our fossil machine. So, yeah, I'll see you guys in a sec. Okay, welcome back, everyone. So, yeah, I did a little bit of mining, but I had to cut my trip a little bit short because I ran out of wood. Yeah, that wasn't too smart. But we did actually get quite a lot of good stuff. I wish I could have stayed on there longer, but I actually ran out of wood, so I couldn't make any more torches. And then I wanted to make a shovel, but I didn't have any wood to make the handle. And everything went downhill from there. But we do actually have quite a lot of nice stuff in here. We've got 64 iron ore there and another 11. We've got 13 gold. We've got 40 bauxite, which is the main reason why I went down, and some bits and pieces. So I've got some glass in there. Interesting. Let's get rid of some of this trash for now. It's got some money in there, but we don't need it just yet. I've got some lapis, cobblestone. We'll get rid of that. One piece of sand, load of gravel. Let's go and stick that berry in here. Boop. There we go. So we didn't really need our Pokeballs because, to be honest, nothing really spawned down there. I did see a few things. I saw Ghastly, Clefairy, that kind of thing. But yeah, nothing too special. So let's get that bauxite smelting first, because that's kind of like our main sort of goal. I think we should have a chest for ores. I think we should probably put them in. Let's put them in this one. So let's stick some glowstone dust, some redstone, some lapis. Let's have this one for like Pokemon stuff. So there's some revives. Let's stick an orb in there for now. I didn't really find any more any shards at all. I think we're just in the wrong biome basically. So we got a little bit unlucky there, it has to be said, but what can you do? So we have our obsidian. What did I do with that redstone? We're gonna need a little bit of redstone, like so. Let's just grab a few of those. Let's actually double check this recipe here. Oh god, wrong button. Where is it? There it is. So we're gonna have to get a load of aluminium plate. We're gonna need one redstone. So one redstone, a ton of plates. Ah, what we could do actually is we can go and get ourselves our water buckets whilst we're waiting for that to smelt. So, did I have any iron in my old place? Do not know. I need to make the transfer. I know it's not really that far, but I do need to make the transfer so we can actually get from all our stuff in one location. It would be very, very useful indeed. So let's just go and check, see if we have any iron. I've got a ton of iron ore, so I just have to smelt it. But if we have some handy, one piece. Wow. Wow, indeed. So we've got some aluminium ingots there. Oh, I've got another iron pickaxe. I could have done with that. Although we do have a diamond one now, which is pretty good. I've got some gold ore there, which I might as well take and smelt. The question is there a crafting table anywhere? Not a crafting table. Is there a furnace anywhere around here? Or should I just wait until my aluminium plate is done? Is there still a hammer in here? Yeah, I've still got my hammers. So, yeah, let's run back here quickly. I think maybe the priority should be grabbing ourselves. We're going to need three buckets. So that's not too bad. We've got a ton of ore. We should just make a second furnace, to be honest. That would be a bit easier, wouldn't it? So yeah, let's grab. What did I do with all my rubbish? Did I put it in here? Ah, there we go, cobblestone. So yeah, let's make a second furnace. I'm slightly concerned I didn't bring enough coal with me, which is a little bit of an issue because I've got coal. So let's stick it right on top there. Let's put the coal in and let's do some iron ore. Yeah, there we go. So let's wait for that to smelt. Now, what else am I going to need for this? What was that again? Ah, that was one obsidian, four redstone. So we can make that now, actually. Let's do one obsidian. I've completely forgotten what it was like. Was it like that? Yes, it was. Okay, so that's our first point, which is the display. So now we just need the tank, and we need the other two bits. So a lot of that is just aluminium plates. It's not too bad. And we do have one fossil, which I think is pretty much ready to go. I don't know how many fossils there are, but I imagine there's probably quite a lot of them. So quite excited about that. That's quite a lot of aluminium already, which is pretty good. I think that might actually be enough for all of our recipes. We don't have enough iron, though, so that is the issue. So, yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to wait for this iron to smelt, and then what I'll also do is I'll hammer out a load of aluminium plates, because they do take a little while, so, yeah, I'll hammer out all of those, and I will meet you back when we have all of our stuff ready to go. Okay, so yeah, I think we actually have enough now. Our hammer is nearly dead though, so yeah, that does take quite a while to hammer out the plates. But we've got 14 aluminium plates here, so whilst I was doing that, hopefully all of my iron has actually smelted, which is kind of the hope, so we can actually get our buckets, and we do have a lot of glass, so glass panes aren't going to be the problem. We do actually have some glass panes left, some glass panes left over from the house, so I think everything should be coming up, thanks to you. Why is that only on 7? Oh, there we go, happy days. Aluminium ingots. Let's store these away in the valuables chest for that, because it's pretty good to have those. Let's actually stick. Actually, we'll just wait for that to finish. Let's just go and make ourselves some buckets. Oh, God. I was a bit eager there with the old iron. Do buckets stack nowadays? Why can't I? I think they do, don't they? Yes! Oh, Mojang. So that's kind of cool. Ooh, glass panes. Glass panes before we forget. Why do I keep saying glass planes? There we go, glass panes. So I think we have everything we need. Let me just double check here. We've already got that piece. We've got our redstone. We've got that, which is fine. We can make a green tank, or we can make an orange tank. That's pretty cool. So we can change the color of it if we want, but I don't think we will. Have we got enough redstone? Let's just grab a couple more. Just in case. Don't want to derp up at this stage. Let's go and grab ourselves some water. Where is the water? There's a big river over here, isn't there? Let's go and grab that. Oh, Ekids! Why always you? There we go. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Okay, so let's just grab ourselves some water here from the Lake of Wonder. Hey, there we go. And I think that's kind of good. So, oh, I also thought as well what would be quite cool is that room that I showed you at the beginning, which doesn't really have that much in it. I thought that would be a really nice place for our fossil extractor and all of our like fossil-y style gear so we can get our cleaner in there and all that stuff. So I thought that would be a decent idea. What we're going to do for the meantime, though, is I'll probably jazz it up a little bit. Have we got a shears yet? I'll probably jazz it up a little bit for next episode. But for now, let's just kind of cut away the floor here. Oh, these shears are a bit eager. Ooh, and it's broken. Damn it. All right, let's do the rest by hand. So let's just get rid of these for now. Because what we can do is... we can put down our wood on the floor. So let's do that. Oops, that wasn't supposed to go there. And that wasn't supposed to go there either. And that just grew back. Go away. Ah, I'll put my bucket down. There we go. Less speed, more haste. Okay, let's just stick that there. Oh, one sec. Oh, sorry about that. We are back. Let me just stick that down. Let me stick that down there. Where's my axe? There she is. Oh, for God's sake. Just stick that there. There you go. So, yeah, I'll jazz this up a little bit more for second episode, make it all look neat and tidy. But I thought maybe our fossil machine on there might be a quite good idea. So let's go and make the rest of these now. So what we need to do is we need three water buckets down the middle. Where is it? There we go. And then we need three glass panes either side. Boom, that's our tank. Oh, we got the buckets back. That's pretty cool. And now what we need is we need aluminium plates on the bottom. That's our base. And then the top bit, I think, was that, wasn't it? Yes, it was. And then we put all four in the machine. So we go there. That goes on the top. That goes on the bottom. The reader goes on the side. Fossil machine. Yeah. So let's stick this bad boy down here right in the middle. Let's go maybe here. Oh my God, it's massive. Oh, how cool is that? That is so awesome. Have I got my fossil on me? And typical, I've not got it with me. Let's go and grab it. Where would I have put it? Actually, let's get rid of some of this stuff whilst we're here. So actually, I'm going to keep those plates because they're pretty valuable. They do take a little while to kind of get hold of, which is a bit of a pain. Let's keep things a bit neat and tidy. Let's put the obsidian in there, actually. Let's get this nice and tidy. We've got one more item frame left over, which is cool. Ooh, our fossil cleaner. Let's actually... we'll stick that down there in a second. Let's go and grab our fossil. I thought I had it with me, but obviously... nope. So let's just run across. Let's bump into a boss along the way. No, we won't. I've not seen a boss for a while, actually. It's been a good few episodes. Maybe I'm just getting unlucky. All right, there's our fossil. So this is the first fossil we've got. We haven't got any more, have we? No. That's a shame. It would be quite cool to have another fossil. But yeah, I'm sure we'll find loads. I would quite like to... see, the one thing I haven't made yet is a Pokedex, which seems really bizarre, but we really should have a Pokedex. You are the tiniest Persian in the world. You little. Yeah, we should really have a Pokedex by now. We'll do that next episode. But yeah, I want to see how many potential fossils we can get. That would be quite cool. So let's open this bad boy. How do we do this? Do we just right-click on it? Oh! Oh my God, that's amazing. Working. How long is this going to take? 2%, 3%, 4%. Oh man, this is gonna take ages. It's very cool though, don't you think? Yeah, I like that a lot. So let's put a fossil cleaner down there. We could actually, it's quite dark here. We could do some torches, but I haven't got any because I'm run out. Right, okay, I'll meet you guys when this is a little bit closer. This is on 11%, so this might take a little while. Ooh, I thought I'd show you this. So we're not actually at the end yet, but I didn't know it did this. So it actually like puts the fossil, the Pokemon, really small. And then the more percentage it goes, the bigger and bigger the actual Pokemon gets, which is a really, really nice effect. I like that. So I just thought I'd show you this in case you've never seen it before. As you can see, that is our Pokemon that we've made from our first fossil. And yeah, it's coming along nicely. So yeah, here she comes. 95, 96. 97, 98, 99, and da-da-da, insert Pokeball. So let's pick our Premier Ball because we've just got it handy. How do we insert it? Oh, retrieve Pokemon. Yay! Ah, oh, it's got sent to my computer. God damn it. I need to get a computer up here, really, don't I? All right, so let's just head to the Poker Center quickly. Because I like the Poker Center bit. It's nice. So we've made our first fossil. I love the way you do that. That's really, really cool. I definitely think one of my little challenges is to try and... You're a different color. A boss graphic. Yes. The thing could wait. Jeff, go. I choose you. Oh, that's level 75. This could be a Thunderstone. This could be a Thunderstone. I'm excited. Giraffic is electric, so that was a waste, wasn't it? Let's just slam it. Oh, that's not very powerful, but we'll chip it away. If all else fails, we have Kyogre to clean it up. But hopefully we can kill this with just some slams. I'm happy we found a boss as well. That's cool. It's been a good episode, don't you think? It's been a good episode. I've enjoyed this episode a lot. Oh, we're so close. Go on, bro. Go on, Jeff. Let's do this. Let's do this for the rest of the team. Ah, I've missed. One more. Yes. No, one more. Go. Oh, for God's sake, slam it. Kill it. Yes. There we go. So we have killed it. So, ooh, it's grown a level. And we got an orange berry and a level ball. Ah, I was hoping for a Thunderstone or something. Oh, well. Is Giraffic electric? I think so. I can't quite remember. Oh, well. Never mind. That's a bit of a shame. Every time I see a slightly green one, I'm just like, oh my god, it's a boss. But yeah, okay. So we did really well. The bosses are... We're getting to the level now where we can take the bosses with our like proper team Pokemon, which is kind of cool. Bisharp served me really, really well. I've got quite a soft spot for it. It's grown on me a lot because it has served us really well in the past with all of the leveling and stuff. Hello, Crocknaw. But yeah, let's go and check out our first fossil Pokemans, which is now in our computer. So we'll deposit someone for now. Who can we deposit? Let's just stick our legendary in there for now, just to keep it safe. And then let's grab ourselves this bad boy. Hey, Mom. How the hell did we grab you? Am I being stupid? Oh, there we go. So yeah, let's grab ourselves. Oh God, that's the wrong button. A level one. Oh God, it's level one. Yay. So this is our first fossil. This is our level one Archon. I don't really know if I'm going to level any of these up, to be honest, but it's kind of cool to have. Oh, you're so cute. But yeah, this is our first fossil hatched Pokemon. So very, very cool indeed. Oh, it flies. That's amazing. So yeah, I think that's about it for this episode, to be honest. Thank you so much for watching, coming back and enjoying more Pixelmon with me. If you enjoyed this episode, please remember to leave a like on it. Really, really helps support the series and shows that people are enjoying it and stuff. So yeah, a like is always super, super appreciated. Also, if you're not yet subscribed, go for it. We do Minecraft Done Fun. But until next episode, thank you once again for watching. It's been such a pleasure. As always, thanks. See ya.